In this screencast, we're going to use the enthalpy concentration diagram to work through an example, specifically that of a condenser that might be used in a separation scheme. So the first place I'd like to start is with just a schematic to fill in the information that we know. So let's draw our condenser, and we have a feed stream that's coming in. We have a vapor stream that's leaving and a liquid stream that's leaving. So I'll label them as liquid, vapor, and feed. We know that we have 100 kilograms per hour of ethanol water mixture. We also know that the liquid is 3 times the vapor flow rate. The temperature of our condenser is 82 degrees Celsius. Pressure is 98 kilopascals, and that our feed is a saturated vapor. So we're removing some amount of heat from this feed stream to cause our partial condensation to occur. So at this point with our schematic, we would want to do a material balance, and we could write an overall material balance. It says that our feed stream is going to be equal to our vapor plus our liquid. We know that our liquid is 3 times our vapor flow rate. So if we plug in the information that we're given, we can solve for both the vapor flow rate and the liquid flow rate. However, we're not given any information about the compositions. So we have to use our phase equilibrium information, knowing that we have a vapor and a liquid at 82 degrees Celsius and 98 kilopascals. This is where the diagram comes in. So we know that we're at 82 degrees at phase equilibrium. So let's zoom into this area. And if we focus on the 82 degrees Celsius line and know that we have both vapor and liquid, then we know the composition of those two streams. All we have to do is read it off of the x-axis. So for the vapor stream, drawing a line down, we have a composition of roughly about 0.73. And if we were going to do this for the liquid, it's about 0.41. So let's use those two values. So our mass composition of our vapor stream, 0.73 kilograms ethanol per kilogram. And in the liquid stream, we said this was about 0.42. So now that we have a composition for both our vapor stream and our liquid stream, we can do a material balance to solve for the composition of our feed stream. So let's go ahead and do that. An ethanol balance says that some amount, and we typically will use Z for the feed to indicate our mass or mole fraction, times 100 kilograms an hour for our feed is going to be equal to 0.73 kilograms of ethanol per kilogram times our vapor flow rate, which we said was 25 kilograms an hour. This is plus our liquid mass fraction, 0.42, times our liquid mass flow rate. So when we solve for the mass fraction of ethanol in our feed stream, we get 0.498, or 0.5 kilograms ethanol per kilogram. So this suggests that we have a equal mass mixture of ethanol and water coming into our condenser. So we've determined the composition in our feed stream as well as the compositions in our liquid and vapor streams. You could easily figure out what the mass fraction composition of water in those streams is, since we know it's just a binary system. It's just going to be 1 minus those fractions to determine that for water. So the next thing to do is to do the energy balance, since we want to determine how much energy is removed from our feed stream. So if we look at an energy balance, we know that the enthalpy, specific enthalpy of our feed times our feed flow rate plus energy that's added must be equal to the specific enthalpy of the vapor times the vapor flow rate, as well as the specific enthalpy of the liquid times the liquid flow rate. So we know the flow rates. We're looking for Q. So we need some way to determine the specific enthalpies of each of the three streams. Again, this is where the composition diagram comes into play. We've determined that we have a 50% composition of ethanol in our feed stream, and it's a saturated vapor. So if we go to 50% and we work up this line to our saturated vapor line, we can read this off of the y-axis to determine what the enthalpy of our feed is. And we could do the same thing with our liquid stream as well as our vapor stream. So all I'm going to do is read this enthalpy to get our specific enthalpy of our vapor, and this gives us our specific enthalpy of our liquid. So if I look at the feed stream first, this is pretty close to 450 kilocals per kilogram. If we look at our vapor stream, when I get the ruler out, I get about 357 kilocals per kilogram. And I know that's a stretch, but that's the best I could do reading off of this plot. And the enthalpy of our liquid stream, again using a ruler, I get about 67 kilocals per kilogram. So let's go ahead and plug these values into our energy balance and solve for Q. So the enthalpy of our feed was 450 kilocals per kilogram. And we know we have 100 kilograms per hour plus Q. Has to equal the enthalpy of our vapor, which we said is 357 kilocals per kilogram, times our vapor flow rate of 25 kilograms per hour. This is going to be plus our enthalpy of 67 kcal per kilogram. Again, these are specific enthalpies of our streams, times our flow rate. When we do this and solve for Q, I get negative 31,050 kcals per hour. So that's the amount of energy we would need to remove from the stream. We didn't even know the temperature, but again, using the composition diagram, we could easily determine this. If we look at the point where we have an enthalpy of 450 on our saturated vapor line, this falls in line with 93 degrees Celsius. So if we have a saturated vapor, then we know it's at 93 degrees Celsius. So going from 93 degrees Celsius to 82 in our drum, with no change in pressure, we'd have to remove 31,050 kcals per hour, and that would give us the split that was specified in our problem statement.